is a big day for me. I've decided to go all high tech and buy myself a new computer, or PC as we say in the trade.
Then you need a power source inside your PC that offers...
I've seen those ads with happy families all having fantastic out of computer experiences, and I definitely want one.
They said someday you'll find...
But which one? Step into a computer shop and you'll have your mind blown by the amount of PCs on the market. If, like me, you don't know the difference between a 486 and a Centronics interfacer, and you think a PCI bus is something you have to catch to go to the computer shop, you're in big trouble. So what you need is some expert advice, which I just happen to have. Richard, there's so much to choose from. Where does someone like me, who knows absolutely nothing about computers, where do I start? I don't want to get anything that's too clever dicky.
The thing to do is to make sure that you get one that's right for you at the moment and that you can expand or upgrade as time goes by. First of all, we've got to decide what's right for you. I mean, what do you think you're going to use it for?
I don't want a computer that I'm scared of. I said I don't know how to use computers, or I never have done, really. My little girl's 11. She uses them. She knows how to use them because of school.
Right.
So things for Emily more than anything
sounds
else.
Sounds like
really.
we need a family PC, which is a multimedia PC. So something with speakers, a CD-ROM drive, some good memory, a good hard drive, something the whole family can use. The first thing to get your head around is the processor. The processor is the brain of the computer, and that's measured in something called megahertz. That's its speed.
Right.
Just think of it as miles an hour. It's like a car. The faster it goes, the better it is, and the faster it'll get you to your destination.
But then if you're a novice like me, do you want a fast computer?
As far as you're concerned, you want a family PC that we're going to play games on.
Right.
I would say we'd need at least a 75 megahertz.
Right.
Yeah, let's have a look. There's a thing on here that will show us the difference. Now you can see how fast this is coming up.
Mm-hmm.
This is whizzing really quickly. And that's going to be done in about 10, 11 seconds. In fact, 11 seconds. There you go. This old-style processor, it's still working. It's still having to draw the picture. And we're now 30 seconds into it, and it's still having to think about it.
All right. OK, so that's the brain of the computer. What else should I look for?
Let's go and have a look at the memory.
Memory.
This one.
Memory. 75 megahertz memory.
There's two main types of memory.
Yeah.
The first type is the storage memory. You've probably heard of disks.
Yeah.
Yeah? Well, that's where the information is stored on the computer, and it's stored on a thing called a hard disk. And the size of the hard disk is measured in what's called megabytes. Now, when you're buying a PC, you probably don't want anything less than about 500 megabytes. Otherwise, you're not going to have enough space to store all of it.
75 megahertz, 500 megabytes.
Excellent. Right. Okay, got that?
No.
Right.
No. This is the memory now.
The memory, the storage.
How much the computer can retain,
yeah.
How much...
It's like a big cupboard. When you want information, you put it in the cupboard, and you want a cupboard that's going to be at least 500 big.
Right.
Okay, you can get a cupboard that's 1,000 big.
Right.
But 500 big is what you'll probably get away with.
Okay.
Okay?
I'm feeling stupid, aren't I a fool?
Now, the second type of memory is called RAM, which stands for Random Access Memory. And this is the working memory. This is what the computer uses when it's thinking. It stores information up in the air. You know, like a juggler juggles balls.
Yeah.
Okay, and what he does is juggling them up in the air so that he can get hold of them quickly, and that's what the computer does. It juggles the information up in the air, and the bigger the RAM, the more arms it's got. It's like a juggler having 8 arms instead of 2 arms. He can juggle many more balls in the air. He's got 16 arms, he can juggle a lot more, and he's a lot quicker at getting the information that he wants. Memory's quite expensive.
Right.
Okay, I mean, 4 megabytes of RAM will probably cost you about £100.
Right.
So it's quite a big leap to go out and say, right, I'm going to get 16 megabytes of RAM, another 8, that's going to be £200.
Mm-hmm.
If you haven't got that £200, then get it at a later stage. As more software comes out that needs more memory, because that's the way it works, new software comes out, it's always very, very memory demanding. You want to be able to say, well, I've got some slots in there, I'll go out, I'll buy some more memory, plug it in, and it'll upgrade my computer.
Right.
Better think twice, don't say we're parting bad friends.
Right, so we've got processor, RAM...
And you'll like this one. Last but not least, it's the quad-speed CD-ROM drive.
I hate you.
This is the CD-ROM drive in here. If I press the button, it'll open up. That's a CD. It's exactly the same as the stuff that you listen to your music on.
Now, see, that to me, that looks normal. This I can relate to.
Yeah, it's
I can understand this. This is a CD disc.
Yeah, but if someone had shown that to you 10 years ago, you'd have gone,
oh, yeah, no.
That's horrible.
Yeah.
I don't like
so, yes, I can understand what this is about.
It's called CD-ROM. because it's read-only memory. You put it in your computer and you close it. And again, you want something that's going to be quite fast, and a minimum is quad speed. We've got some very exciting software, which we'll have a look at later. That CD there holds about 100 times as much information as one of the floppy disks.
Right, so you tell me all the things I need to look for in the computer that's right for me, but, I mean, there's hundreds here. How do I choose the computer that's coming home with me?
OK, we're quite lucky because this is a big store, and every computer in here is from a named manufacturer. What you don't want to do is go to a store where they're going to sell you something from a company you've never heard of, because there's a danger that they might go out of business, you won't get the support that you want, you won't get the service that you want, so you want a company that's going to be around for some time.
OK, great. So, company that I'm... So can I buy one now, please?
Not quite. We've only looked at the hardware so far. Now we're going to have a look at the software.
Next week?
Yeah, see you then.
OK.
Bye.